Niklesh, we don't have an idea for a video this week. What do we do?
Yeah, even I don't have any ideas. Maybe I'll search online.
We'll figure something out.
Kushal! Niklesh. Hey guys, I'm Niklesh.
And I'm Kushal. We're the two broke scientists.
That's right. Today's video is about vortices. But what exactly is a vortex?
Simple. A vortex is a fluid particle rotating about a center. The question is, why? Also, is the physics of a sink vortex similar to that of a cyclone? Or even the polar vortex?
Take a look at water in the sink. Doesn't it look like it's still? Well, yes and no. In reality, there's always a very small amount of rotation that's present, either because of the way we unplug the sink or the way we fill it up. When the drain is unplugged, gravity causes the water to rush down, and during this motion, the rotation is intensified and we see the sink vortex.
So a sink vortex is gravity driven. But a cyclone is caused by the warming of the ocean. Warm ocean water starts rising, creating a low pressure region on the surface. The rising water meets the cold air in the sky and forms clouds. While the hot air rises, the Earth's rotation causes it to spin in a phenomenon called the Coriolis effect. It is also because of this effect that we see cyclones and hurricanes rotating in opposite directions in the northern and the southern hemisphere. For an understanding of the Coriolis effect, check out the link in the description. Interesting fact. The Coriolis component is also present in a sink. But a sink is tiny in comparison to a hurricane. So the effect of Earth rotation is negligible and the Coriolis component can be ignored.
But vortices are not just gravity or temperature driven. We see them everywhere, from the whirlpools in the ocean to the wingtip vortices behind an aircraft and even the polar vortex, which is causing freezing temperatures across the Midwest. All these vortices are caused by different effects. But they have one thing in common, the conservation of angular momentum.
Figure skaters use their arms to increase the speed of their rotation. This is exactly what happens in a vortex. In a sink vortex and a cyclone, there is net movement of fluid towards the center. And as the particles of fluid come closer to the center, due to conservation of angular momentum, they start spinning faster and faster. And that's how different vortices are formed.
Let's now try to visualize the velocity field around a vortex. Formulas can be pretty confusing, but the formula for velocity around a vortex is actually pretty simple. It's inversely proportional to the radius from the center. This means that as the radius keeps decreasing, the velocity of the fluid increases rapidly. But a real fluid has viscosity, which means it's not possible to infinitely increase the velocity of the fluid. At some point, the viscous forces dominate and start slowing down the fluid. This is what the velocity profile looks like. And this is why the eye of the storm is the most calm.
The velocity profile you just saw is called a Rankine vortex in fluid mechanics. Clearly, there are two distinct regions. One where viscosity plays a role, causing the particles to rotate about their own axis as well as revolve about its center. The rotation of the fluid particles about its own axis is called vorticity. The fluid away from the center isn't affected by viscosity and remains irrotational, meaning that it does not rotate about its own axis.
Okay. Things are about to get a little dizzy. Many times, rotational motion is confused with vorticity. But rotational motion refers to motion about a common center, while vorticity refers to rotation about its own center. In a Rankine vortex, all the particles rotate about a common center, but only the particles close to the center rotate about their own axis as well.
The Rankine vortex is one of the basic models used to understand the behavior of cyclones and hurricanes.
Weather prediction involves a lot of fluid mechanics to understand the dynamics of air patterns around the world. Even the more recent polar vortex has a lot of fluid mechanics involved. For a better understanding of the polar vortex, make sure to check out Simon Clark's video.
That was a lot of information. Hopefully now you understand what is a vortex and how it's important in weather prediction.
Thanks for watching our video.
And we hope you enjoyed it.
For some cool bloopers, don't forget to check out our Instagram page.
And finally, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
Bye!